I pounded hard on Mandy's door.
Pretty soon, her dad opened the door. When I saw him there, looking down at me, with sweat standing out in little droplets on his upper lip, I couldn't say anything. I just stood there, with my knees shaking, and I stared at him. The gift of friendship is one of the most valuable treasures in life. There's nothing you wouldn't do to protect the ones you love. But what happens when you never see or hear from them again? This is Missing Mandy by Peg Kehret. Last year, on the first day of school, Mandy and I walked together. I miss Mandy a lot. It might not be so bad if I can write to her and get letters back from her, but to have her leave like she did and not know where she went, well, that's the hard part. I always wonder what would happen if I told sooner. Would she still have moved away and not let anyone know where? Last year, when school started, I didn't know anything about Mandy's trouble. She never told anyone, not even me. I always thought she wore long sleeve shirts because she liked them. I didn't know her to cover up the bruises. One day, Mandy came to school with her hand bandaged. She said she burned it baking cookies. But that day, Miss Swenson asked me to stay after school. When we were alone, she asked me if I thought Mandy had really burned herself baking cookies. I told her, Mandy wouldn't pretend to be burned if she wasn't. Miss Swenson was sure the burn was real, but she wasn't convinced it was accidental. I didn't know what she meant. And then one day, Mandy was supposed to come over so we can study, and she didn't come. When I went to her house to go get her, I heard her crying. What's worse, I heard why she was crying. I can hear her dad beating on her something fierce. I got a sick feeling inside, and I didn't know what to do. Finally, I found a heart on Mandy's door. And pretty soon, her dad opened the door. When I saw him there looking down at me with sweat standing out in little droplets, I couldn't say anything. I just stood there with my knees shaking, and I stared at him. He told me that he wasn't feeling well and for me to go home. I did. I went home. I sat on my bed in the dark, but I couldn't stop shaking, even after I crawled under the covers and I put my pillow over my head. I stayed home the next day. I told Mama I felt sick, and that was the truth. Mama asked me what was wrong, but I couldn't tell her. Would things have turned out different if I did? I went back to school, and a few weeks later, Mandy showed up with a cast on her arm. She said she fell down her basement steps, but there was an odd farewell look in her eye when she told me. That day, I stayed after school, and I told Miss Swenson about standing on Mandy's porch. She kept nodding her head as if it wasn't at all a surprise. Miss Swenson said I did good to tell her. I don't know if I was right or not, but that day, a police car showed up at Mandy's house, and nobody was home. They went back the next day, and Mandy was gone. Her and her dad must have moved out in the night because nobody saw where they went, and nobody knows where they could have gone. Miss Swenson isn't my teacher anymore, and this year I went to school alone. I hope Mandy isn't walking alone wherever she is. I hope she has a friend to talk with. Most of all, I hope Mandy is wearing a short sleeve.